Hello everyone and welcome back to a new Mac Detect video. Today's episode is about Power BI, the long-awaited Power BI, the Excel rival that we were looking up to see and to understand what's the difference between Excel, the normal Excel, Power Query and Power BI. Well, to start, we need to understand what is Power BI. Then we need to understand why do we need to use Power BI. The third thing that we need to know, what data sources you can connect to the Power BI. And what makes Power BI a useful tool? What is Power BI visualization and what makes it apart from Excel? So, without further ado, let's go! So to start, what is Power BI? Now, if you go to the Power BI website, powerbi.com, and you go and check about what is Power BI, they will have all these fancy things calling it about Power BI and how amazing it is as a tool to use, and so wonderful to go over it and understand the concept that Microsoft put in for Power BI. But to me, I want to make it simple. So what is Power BI? Actually, to me, Power BI is a tool that allows you to connect to any form of data or data warehousing or even a platform that will allow you to take the right business decision based on the hidden information in your data by making it visualized and appealing so that you can immediately know what to do. This is my own perspective about Power BI and how I look at this tool and how I analyze the different information that I see. When to use Power BI? This is a controversial question because you can use Excel for what I know, but Power BI is very good in crunching big data sources. And when you have like multiple sources that you are connecting to, you are connecting to CRM, you are connecting to your ERP system, you are connecting to a data warehousing model, you are connecting to the cloud, to SharePoint, Azure, whatever. If you have those multiple sources that you want to connect and too many different platforms, Excel can do something like that, but it will take you like a 10 times the effort to make it on Excel. Whereas in Power BI, the data modeling and the connections that is done on the Power BI is pretty amazing and it is strong. So you can reach whatever you want so fast and you can just right away manipulate. Now, before we start, who can work on Power BI? Actually, if you know Excel, you're halfway there. If you know Power Query, you're 80% there. So you can see Power Query and Excel are like the smaller brothers of Power BI. So if you know how to use these, you can jump over to Power BI with a little bit of tweaking here and there, and you're good to go. Before we start, hit the subscribe button, like or dislike will do just fine. Activate the bell icon to receive all new episodes released on this channel as soon as possible. To start using Microsoft Power BI, you can download it from several places. One of the places that you can download Power BI is from the Power BI website. You can go to Power BI website and download it from there. But I found that downloading it from Microsoft Store is better. Why do you think is downloading it from Microsoft Store is better? Because simply, in the Microsoft Store, you can have it automatically updated and receiving all the new updates directly when they are there. So all you have to do, go to the store, write Power BI, and please download the Power BI desktop. This is the desktop or the designer that you will use for Power BI. Okay. So as you see, I have it already downloaded in my PC, so I can immediately launch it immediately from the store. Or I can go to the start and click on it and it will turn on. Now that we have Power BI is turned on, let's explore the Power BI a little bit. The Power BI, it has now, as you can see, the ribbon, which is a very familiar thing for Excel. You can understand the ribbon by just reading through all these elements like the file that we all know, the home, the insert, the modeling, the view, and the help. You can go and explore all these tabs to understand more about them. The fields,
And here you will see all the data sources that you will connect to. The visualization, these are the charts that you can use and that you can utilize in your report or dashboard. And the filters, these are the filters that you can apply to all your visualizations, whether on a certain visualization or on a filter on this page, or you can filter it across all the report. Now, in here, you see the report. In here, you will see the data. And in here, you will see the model. The model is the most important thing that you can do in your report. So please take good care of this, because this will make it or break it in all your Power BI projects. And here you can find the different, you can add as many pages to your report. I found that 5 to 6 or 10 pages maximum is the best. Otherwise, the Power BI will be very heavy and will be difficult to be utilized in your job. So what types of data sources you can connect to Power BI? Actually, you can connect plenty of power sources, more than 70, I think, till now. So if you press more, you can see the different types or sources that you can connect to Power BI. You can have it from Excel, text, CSV file, XML, JSON, folders, PDF, SharePoints. You can scroll down and see how many sources that you can get data from. And that's why the Power BI is so powerful. And that's why you can use it more than when you can utilize an Excel, because it is like cross-platform thing. And here you can see the different categories of this one, like SharePoint, Exchange, Dynamics 365, which is CRM, Google Analytics. You can connect to whatever sources you want. We are going to explore one of the Power BI samples available on Microsoft website. And this sample is free for anyone to use. And this sample will elaborate a lot about what the visualization are. So if you go to overview, and you can see here, the sources are refreshing. And this is how nice it is. So you can see all these sources. These are called visualizations in Power BI. What you can do in the visualizations is, once you click on one visualization, you will see the filters on this visualization or on this visual. So there is no filters here, because you can see the DM here, there is nothing. I can select one guy instead of all these people, or I can select two people. And this way you can see DM is both this one and this one, and this visualization is only impacted by this filter. Whereas if I take the chain and I say fashion district, this will make the report, all the report on this page, filtered like this, not except a visualization. It's actually all the visualization here that are affected. If I want to see a city and I select, for example, this one, then I see only the city with all these visualization only to this city. So you can see this filter is very, very powerful. At the same time, you can add filters to all the pages. So say, for example, in this district, DM, I want to filter on all the pages only for this guy. And it immediately filters everything on this and this. Right now, you can see that there are 10 stores, 10 new stores, total 104 stores. You can see so many things. At the same time, what makes it so powerful is that you can click on this lenses here, and you filter everything here. So just by clicking on this bar, you filtered everything to see only on this bar. If I click on the other one, you can see the filter, and you can see how interactive it is. It is happening as we speak. We are seeing all these changes taking place. If you click on it again, the visualization is back. If you click on this bubble here, You see, you filter everything to this bubble. At the same time, you can see that the size of this bubble in terms of the store sales overview. And you can see here the breakdown in monthly sales of the district. And everything is the same. You can see these are like desktop filters, so you can use them on the Power BI app on your mobile or on your iPad for you to take the right business decisions for your company or for your business. On top of this, there is a lot of things that you need to know about Power BI. One of the things is the data model. And let's go and see the data model. This is like the very important thing in this, because it dictates how the report is interacting between filters and between the so many different information available. So you can see the stores, the district, the time. Timetable is so important in Power BI because data is stored based on time. So you will have to see like which year, which month, and all these stuff. And this is very important. The way you interact with the model is the most important thing using your Power BI. Based on this data, let's try to make a visualization of our own. So for example, if I take this visualization, which is the pie, and I want to see, let's take total sales. The nice thing is that you can check it with district, so I go and put it in the details here, or in the legend, it will give me the same thing. So you can see, I can immediately form a nice visualization for that. To add a good thing for this, I can add a filter, and now you can see the power of the filter. So for example, if I take the filter and I put the DM here, and you can see now I have a small filter and I can see these stuff here in the filter. Now imagine if I want to see another filter, another visualization, and this visualization is about total sales as well. So check it out now. You can see we've built this visualization just like with a couple of drops, and that's it, and it's done. That's why the Power BI is so powerful. And the most important thing is for you to understand that Power BI utilizes also a query model. So you can do a lot of stuff on the data, keeping the raw data clean as much as possible, and make all the changes that you want to do on the query itself.
This is the first episode I do in English, and I decided to switch a little bit, to change a little bit, and to speak in a different way, and to try to address more big audience. I'll do my best to put subtitles in Arabic language in the video. And I hope that you find this information value to you and to your organization. Let me know in the conversation if you would like to see more about Power BI and more about Power BI data modeling, because the trick in Power BI is all about data modeling. For now, please support me to grow the channel, to reach bigger audience and spread knowledge. For time being, adios, amigos.